In today's lecture, we are going to study about some of the numericals on the topic of Carnot's ideal heat engine. Let us try to find the efficiency of Carnot's engine working between the steam point and the ice point. Now, we have seen how can we calculate the efficiency of a Carnot's engine. Now, in this case, what we are given in the question is that we have two temperatures. One is the steam point, that is the high temperature is the steam point temperature, and the low temperature is the ice point temperature. So in this case, we can say that T1, that is the temperature of the hot source or the heat source, heat reservoir T1, is 100 degrees Celsius. And we'll convert it into Kelvin by adding 273. So we have 373 Kelvin. Then the low temperature, that is T2, is ice point, that is 0 degrees Celsius. So again, by adding with 273, you'll get 273 Kelvin. We are asked to find the efficiency of the Carnot's engine. The efficiency of the Carnot's engine is given by eta, which is equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. So it's very easy. You just have to put up the values for T2 and T1 in this equation. We have T2 as equal to 273. And T1 as 373. So let us substitute in this equation. So this becomes 1 minus 273 upon 373. When you solve this, you will get it as equal to 26.81%. To find efficiency in percentage, we will just multiply this term with 100. So in this case, if you divide, this will be 373 minus 273 divided by 373. That gives you 100 upon 373. And 100 upon 373 will be 0.2681. When you multiply it with 100, you will get this as 26.81%. So this is the way we can find the efficiency of the Carnot's engine working between the steam point and the ice point. Now let us see the second question. Now in this question, we are going to find the efficiency of Carnot's engine which is working between 127 degrees Celsius and 27 degrees Celsius. And it is given that it absorbs 80 calories of heat, and we have to find how much of heat is rejected to the sink. So here we have two temperatures, that is 127 degrees Celsius and the second temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. So the higher temperature will be taken as T1 and the lower temperature is taken as T2. So in the given term, we'll write T1 as equal to 273 plus 127, that is 400 Kelvin. And T2 is 27 degrees Celsius plus 273, that gives you 300 Kelvin. So we have to find what is the heat rejected to the system, that is Q2 is to be calculated. You are given the amount of, that is Q1. So first we can find the efficiency. We know that the efficiency is related to both the heat absorbed and the heat released, and the temperatures, that is T1 and T2. We know that 1 minus Q2 by Q1 is equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. So if you calculate either the efficiency, you will be able to find out what is the heat rejected to the sink. So first we'll calculate the efficiency. The efficiency eta will be equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. When we substitute the values of T2 and T1, we'll get this as 1 minus 300 upon 400. So it is 400 minus 300 upon 400, which again gives you 100 upon 400. That will be 1 by 4. And 1 by 4 is equal to 0.25. In terms of percentage, when you multiply it by 100, you'll get this as 25%. And therefore, we can find now the work done, that is W, which is equal to eta times of Q1. So we have here W, which is equal to eta times of Q1, that is 0.25 multiplied by 80, because 80 is the Q1, that is the amount of heat which is given, which is taken from the source. So this comes out to be equal to 20 calories. Now you can find what is heat rejected, because we know that work done is W is equal to Q1 minus Q2, and therefore Q2 will be equal to Q1 minus W. So the heat rejected will be Q2, that is equal to Q1 minus W, and that will be equal to 80 minus 20, and that is 60 calories. So in this way, you can find the heat which is rejected to the sink, and in this case we have AT, that is the heat which is taken from the source. So first thing was to find out the efficiency, and from this efficiency we can find the work done, and from this work done you can find out what is the heat rejected to the sink. So this is where you can find the second way, that is the heat rejected to the sink. This is another type of question. Let us see one more question. So let's see this question once again. A Carnot's engine, the temperature of the source is 400 Kelvin and it takes 200 calories of heat at this temperature and rejects 150 calories of heat to the sink. What is the temperature of the sink? And we have to calculate the efficiency of the engine. So let us write down the terms. We'll take this Q1 as 200 Kelvin and Q2 the heat rejected is 150 calories. Then T1 is 400 Kelvin, T2 is to be calculated, and also the efficiency is to be calculated. Now we know that Q1 upon T1 is equal to Q2 upon T2. So Q1 by T1 is equal to Q2 by T2, or you can write this T2 by T1 is equal to Q2 by Q1. And on this basis, we can find out what is T2 because all the three other terms are given. And by using this formula, we are going to calculate the efficiency. So in this case, here T2 will be equal to Q2 by Q1 into T1. Put up the values for Q2 and Q1 and T1, and then you can calculate the formula here. This gets cancelled after calculation. We get the term as 300 Kelvin. So you got what is T2. And then we can find out what is efficiency. 1 minus T2 by T1, put up the values. It gives you 1 by 4, and 1 by 4 is 0.25, and the percentage will be 25%. So that's how you can find this, calculate this question. Let us move on to the next question. A Carnot's engine whose lower temperature heat sink is at 27 degrees Celsius and it has efficiency 40%. What is the temperature of the heat source? By how much should the temperature of the source be raised if the efficiency is to be raised to 70%? So what is, there are two different conditions given here. In the first case, when the heat sink is at 27 degrees Celsius, the efficiency is 40%. And we have to find out the temperature of the heat source, that is T1, is to be calculated. Now in the second case, it is asked, by how much we should change or increase the temperature of the source to raise the efficiency to 70%. So we can take these terms, heat sink temperature, let us take it as T2, that is 27 degrees Celsius plus 273 gives you 300 Kelvin. And we'll take eta 1 as the efficiency 40%, 40% from 40 by 100, that is 0.4. And let us take the second efficiency eta 2 as equal to 70%, 70 by 100 is 0.7. Now in the first case, we are asked to find the temperature of the heat source. So the temperature of the heat source. So uske liye hum log eta 1 jo formula hai uska use karenge. Eta 1 will be equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. Or you can write this T2 by T1 as equal to 1 minus eta 1. Isko rearrange kiya humne. Aur yahan se aap T1 find कर सकते हैं, and T1 will be equal to T2 divided by 1 minus eta 1. इसको सिर्फ आपको इधर transfer करना है, and rearrange करके आपको मिल जाएगा. T1 is equal to T2 upon 1 minus eta 1, and we are putting up the values for T2 as 300. ये यहाँ से हमने लिया था. 1 minus eta 1 की value है 0.4, and 1 minus 0.4 is 0.6. So this becomes 3000 divided by 6, and that comes out to be equal to 500 Kelvin. And in terms of degree Celsius, minus 273 will give you 227 degrees Celsius. So the required temperature for the this heat source is 227 degrees Celsius. Now the second thing we have to find is the rise in temperature of the source. So the required rise in the source temperature will be equal to, now let us take this as T1 dash and T1 dash will be equal to T2 divided by 1 minus eta 2. And because we are not changing the temperature of the sink, it will be the same, that is 300, and divided by 1 minus the second efficiency is 70%, so it is 1 minus 0.7. This will be 300 divided by 0.3, will be 3000 divided by 3, and that comes out to be equal to 1000 Kelvin. And 1000 केल्विन का मतलब होता है 727 डिग्री सेल्सियस। अब ये है आपका टेम्परेचर ऑफ द सोर्स, अगर इसकी एफिशिएंसी 70% होती है तो। अब हम फाइंड करेंगे कि कितना टेम्परेचर में राइज होता है, सो इट विल बी टी वन डैश माइनस टी वन, एंड देयरफॉर द रिक्वायर्ड राइज इन टेम्परेचर विल बी टी वन डैश माइनस टी वन, दैट इज इक्वल टू 1000 माइनस 500, दैट इज 500 केल्विन, या फिर आप इसको 727 माइनस 227 करेंगे तो दैट गिव्स यू अगेन 227 डिग्री सेल्सियस। सो 500 केल्विन का मतलब ही होता है 500 माइनस 273, सो दैट विल बी 227 डिग्री सेल्सियस। इन दिस वे वी कैन फाइंड द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द सोर्स, and if the efficiency is to be raised to 70%, then the temperature again has to be raised to by 227 degrees Celsius. The next question is about the Carnot's engine whose low temperature reservoir is at 7 degrees Celsius and it has an efficiency of 50%. It is desired to increase the efficiency to 70%. By how many degrees should the temperature of the heat source be raised? अभी जैसे कि आपको वैसे ही करना है वापस से. So let us take case one. And that in this case we have eta is equal to 50%. That is 0.5. 50 by 100 will be 0.5. And the temperature of the sink T2 is 273 plus 7. That is 280 Kelvin. And we are asked to find T1. That is temperature of the source. The efficiency is given by eta is equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. So here we have eta is equal to 0.5 and this will be 0.5 equal to 1 minus 280 divided by T1. Aur yahan se aapko T1 find karna hai. So therefore, you will get this as T1 is equal to 560 Kelvin. In the second case, we'll get eta dash as equal to 70%, that is 0.7, T2 is equal to 280 Kelvin, and T1 dash aapko find karna hai. So eta dash will be equal to 1 minus T2 by T1 dash, and you have 0.7 is equal to 1 minus 280 upon T1 dash, and therefore T1 dash will be equal to 840 Kelvin, and the increase in temperature will be 840 minus 560, that is 280 Kelvin. So you try to solve this and see what do you get in this case, and calculate and try to find that whether the answer 560 is correct or not, and let me know. Next question is, a Carnot's engine has its source at 100 degrees Celsius and its sink is maintained at constant temperature by means of an ice at 0 degrees Celsius. If it is working at the rate of 100 watts, how much ice will melt in 1 minute? So, yahan par aapko power diya hai, power 100 watts ka, that is 100 joule per second. Now, power ka matlab hota hai ki isme aap find kar sakte work done, it is work done per unit time. So work done in 1 minute can be calculated, and this will be equal to 100 into 60, that is 6000 joules. Now we have T1, that is 100 degrees Celsius, that will be equal to 100 plus 273 is 373 Kelvin. T2 is equal to 0 degrees Celsius, that is 273 Kelvin. Now we know that Q1 minus Q2 upon Q1 is equal to T1 minus T2 upon T1. Ye humne pehle use kiya hai. और Q1 माइनस Q2 की जगह आप W डाल सकते हैं. सो W अपॉन Q1 विल बी इक्वल टू T1 माइनस T2 अपॉन T1, या फिर Q1 बाई Q2 इज इक्वल टू T1 बाई T2, ये भी फॉर्मूला आपके पास है. सो देयरफॉर वी कैन राइट W अपॉन Q1 एज इक्वल टू T1 माइनस T2 अपॉन T1, और इसमें हम Q2 इज इक्वल टू लिखेंगे, इन दिस केस विल राइट दिस Q2 एज इक्वल टू WT2 अपॉन T1 माइनस T2. सो देयरफॉर यू कैन राइट Q2 एज इक्वल टू WT2 अपॉन T1 माइनस T2, एंड दिस विल बी इक्वल टू 6000, दैट इज W इंटू T2 की वैल्यू 273 डिवाइडेड बाय T1 माइनस T2 विल बी इक्वल टू 100. एंड व्हेन यू मल्टीप्लाई दिस टर्म्स यू विल फाइंड द आंसर एज इक्वल टू 16380 जूल्स. सपोज दैट MKG ऑफ आइस मेल्ट्स, देन Q2 विल बी इक्वल टू M इंटू L. नाउ हियर L इज द लैटेंट हीट ऑफ द आइस, सो देयरफॉर यू कैन राइट दिस एज इक्वल टू M इज इक्वल टू Q2 अपॉन L. एंड Q2 हमने देखा है 16380 है, और आइस के लिए लैटेंट हीट की वैल्यू 80 इंटू 10^3 इंटू 4.2 लेना है आपको. एंड देयरफॉर व्हेन यू कैलकुलेट ऑल दिस टर्म्स यू विल गेट दिस एज इक्वल टू 0.04875 kg. तो इसका मतलब होता है कि इतना kg आइस का मेल्ट हो सकता है. सो इन दिस केस वी हैव सीन दैट इफ सपोज दिस इंजन हैज इट सोर्स एट 100 डिग्री सेल्सियस, और सिंक भी है हमारे पास में जिसका कि 0 डिग्री सेल्सियस पर मेंटेन किया हुआ है, और उसका वर्किंग रेट आपको अगर दिया है तो वर्किंग रेट से हम ये पता कर सकते हैं कि 1 मिनट में कितनी आइस मेल्ट हो सकती है. लेट अस सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. ए कर्नोट्स इंजन वर्किंग बिटवीन ए सोर्स टेम्परेचर 27 डिग्री सेल्सियस एंड ए सिंक एट -73 डिग्री सेल्सियस डिलीवर्स 300 कैलोरीज ऑफ हीट टू द लैटर इन 1 साइकिल. कैलकुलेट द वर्क परफॉर्म इन जूल्स बाय द इंजन पर साइकिल. सो इन दिस केस यू कैन नाउ अंडरस्टैंड दैट T1 इज 27 डिग्री सेल्सियस, 27 प्लस 273, 300 दैट इज इक्वल टू, हियर दैट इज इक्वल टू, सो लेट अस चेंज दिस, दिस विल बी हियर इक्वल टू 300 केल्विन. एंड यू कैन राइट T2 एज इक्वल टू -73 प्लस 273 दैट इज 200 केल्विन. You are also given Q2 that is 300 Kelvin and Q1 is to be calculated. We now have the formula Q1 by Q2 is equal to T1 by T2, and therefore you can write Q1 upon 300 is equal to 300 upon 200. So therefore Q1 will be equal to this 300 will be get multiplied here divided by 200. So you will have this term as equal to 450 calories. You can find the work performed per cycle, that is work performed in 1 cycle. W is equal to Q1 minus Q2. And you know that Q1 is 450 and Q2 is 300, that is 150 calories. And calories ko joules mein convert kiya ja sakta hai by multiplying with 4.2. And therefore, this will be equal to 630 joule. So you can find what is the total work done by the engine in 1 cycle. So it is 630 joules. One more question. A Carnot's engine is operated between two reservoirs at temperatures of 450 Kelvin and 350 Kelvin. If the engine receives 1000 calories of heat from the source in each cycle, you are asked to calculate the amount of heat rejected to the sink in each cycle. Calculate the efficiency of the engine and the work done by the engine in 1 cycle. You know that 1 calorie is equal to 4.2 joule. So in this case, T1 is 450 kelvin, and T2 is 350 kelvin, Q1 is 1000 calories, and Q2 is to be calculated. So again, we'll use the formula Q2 by Q1 is equal to T2 by T1, and therefore Q2 is equal to Q1 into T2 by T1. Put up the values and calculate it to get the answer as equal to 777.77 calories. And now you can find the efficiency. Eta is equal to 1 minus T2 by T1, and therefore We can put up the values here, 1 minus 300 upon 400, and this will be equal to, so it is equal to again here. Upon 450, and therefore you have here 10 upon 45, and that gives you 0.22, and percentage is 22.22%, and the work done in each cycle will be Q1 minus Q2, and that will be equal to 1000 minus 777.77, so that is 222.23 calories. And you can find this in terms of joules by multiplying with 4.2. So that gives you 222.23 into 4.2 joules. And that comes out to be equal to 933.33. So this will be equal to 933.33. So let us see the last question. The efficiency of Carnot cycle changes from 1 by 6 to 1 by 3 when a source temperature is raised by 100 Kelvin. Calculate the temperature of the sink. So here we are not given the temperatures, but the efficiency which changes from this value 1 by 6 to 1 by 3 is given. And just it is said that the temperature is changed by 100 Kelvin. So what is the temperature of the sink? So let us see. You know that the efficiency is given by 1 minus T2 by T1. This will be equal to 1 by 6 for the first case. If you take the efficiency as 1 by 6, so it will be 1 minus T2 by T1 is equal to 1 by 6. And from here you can find what is T2 by T1. And T2 by T1 will be equal to 1 minus 1 by 6, which is equal to 5 by 6. Therefore, you can write T1 as equal to 6 by 5 times T2. So, हमें यहाँ पर T1 और T2 के बीच में relationship मिल गया. अब हम second case देखेंगे. In the second case, the efficiency has changed to 1 by 3. And now, when is this happening? When the temperature of the source is increased by 100 Kelvin. तो हम इसको ऐसा लिखेंगे, eta dash will be equal to 1 minus, sink का temperature change नहीं हुआ, वो वही पर है, T2. And the source temperature is increased by 100. So T2 upon T1 plus 100 will be equal to 1 by 3. So therefore, now you can solve this. So yahan se aapko milega, ye jo term agar aapko lena hai, T2 upon T1 plus 100 will be equal to 1 minus 1 by 3. And 1 minus 1 by 3 will be equal to 2 by 3. And therefore, T2 will be equal to, hum isko 2 by 3 into T1 plus 100 karenge. To isko thoda sa aapko rearrange karna hai. इसके बाद का स्टेप में हम लिखेंगे T2 upon T1 plus 100 is equal to 1 minus 1 by 3, that is equal to 2 by 3. Or T2 will be equal to 2 by 3 into T1 plus 100. And इसको अगर आप ओपन करते हैं, you'll get 2 by 3 into T1 plus 2 by 3 into 100. And therefore T2 will be equal to 2 by 3 into T1. Now we have T1 is equal to 6 by 5 times T2. तो यहाँ पर आप इसको डाल सकते हैं. तो आपको मिलेगा T2 is equal to 2 by 3 times of T1 plus 200 by 3. Next step में मैंने डाला यहाँ पर 2 by 3 into 6 by 5 times T2. ये T1 की जगह पर हमने 6 by 5 times T2 डाल दिया plus 200 upon 3. So you'll get 4 by 5 times T2 plus 200 by 3. And यहाँ पर भी आपके पास T2 है, इधर जाके subtract कर देंगे हम लोग. तो this is T2 minus 4 by 5 times T2 will be equal to 1 by 5 times T2 will be equal to 200 upon 3, and therefore T2 will be equal to 1000 divided by 3, that is 333.33 Kelvin. तो इस तरह से हमने find किया temperature of the sink क्या है. अगर आपके पास ये सिर्फ change in efficiency भी देता है, when the source temperature is changed by 100 Kelvin, it means that the sink temperature was constant throughout, and that was 333.33 Kelvin. So that is how we have solved some of the numericals based on this topic of Carnot cycle. So थैंक यू।